Now, what you have to do is, first of all, you have to type your program in Notepad. So here you will get Notepad, and you have to type your program in this file. Now, after that, you have to save your file. So you have to go to File and then Save. In the save, you can choose any location. Suppose I want to choose desktop. So you have to choose desktop, and then here you have to give the name of the file, that is, for example, ABC, and you have to give extension .html. So this is how you have to give the name, as ABC.html, and then click on save. So it will create a folder on your desktop. So as I have created a file with name practical, so this is the file that I have created. So it will create a folder on the desktop. Now you have to check the output of the program. So how you have to check the output of the program? Right click on this file and then open with. You have to open with any of the browser. So I'm going to open with Google Chrome. So let's start with Google Chrome. So this is the output of the program. So you can check, this is marquee tag, which is rotating in right direction, because we have given the direction as right and we have given the text as welcome to my web page. So this is because of marquee tag, and we have applied pink color to the background. So this is pink color in the background, and this is the table that we have created, a table with four rows. You can check 1, 2, 3, 4. There are four rows and three columns. So you can check the first, in the first row, the two columns are spanned. So because we have applied call spanning in the first row, and we have displayed the text as computer science. So this is just because of spanning of columns. So we have performed spanning of two columns. So that's why two columns are combined as a single cell. So this is the heading that we have given in the table, computer science, physics, chemistry. Now in the second row, there are total six cells. You can check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we have entered data in six cells, and then in the third row we have entered information in the six cells, and so on. So this is how we have created a table, and table also has a border because we have applied border tag. Now this is the image that we have applied through image tag, img source. So it has applied an image. Now this image is hyperlinked because we have also applied a hreference tag on the image. Now you can check, look at this cursor. This cursor is in arrow form. It means this is normal web page. But when I move my cursor to this area, you can see that the arrow pointer has changed into new pointer. And this pointer indicates that this is hyperlinked area, because the hand pointer in hand form indicates this is hyperlinked area. Hyperlinked area is area, when we click on that area, it will display some other information. So we have applied hyperlink on the image. So when I click on this image, it displays another page. So this is just another web page that I have attached, because I have told you that I have given the page as hotel.html. So this is the information of hotel.html page. So it has linked our image to that page. So this is the practical, student. This is very simple practical of HTML. You can simply execute at your home. What you have to do is write your code carefully, otherwise it will not generate output, because in HTML will not find errors or display errors. So if it is not displaying output, it means there is something wrong in your code. So write your code carefully. So here I'm displaying the code. You can check and write if you want. So with this, we have completed one practical of HTML. Now, same as you have to attach C++ program, similarly you have to attach HTML program. So what you have to do is you have to attach the coding part as well as you have to attach the snapshot of the output. So this is the code of the program. Now this is the output of the program. You have to take a snapshot and you have to attach the snapshot in the file. So that's all for today.